The Dankhold Troggoth is a large, powerful, but ultimately dim-witted creature that likes to spend most of its time fast asleep underground. However, when roused by the gloom spite, it flies into a terrible rage and likes to smash apart its opponents with its massive fists and huge club. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint this miniature in the purple colour scheme that you can see inside the Gloom Spite Gits Battletome book. And by following the methods and techniques we're going to show you, you'll be able to paint any of the different sorts of Troggoths. So without further ado, let's get started. If, like me, you've decided to build your miniature with a large two-handed club, then we recommend the following sub-assembly. Building most of the body except for the hands and keeping those separate on the club like this, because doing so will allow you to easily access all the detail around the Troggoth's legs. Then you'll need to undercoat your miniature, and for this we recommend Mechanica Standard Grey Spray, and then we need to start out painting it. And the first colour we need is Warp Fiend Grey. Now, as always, remember to give all your paints a really good shake before you use each one, and we're going to be applying quite a lot of this, so I recommend applying it using a large base brush. And what you need to do is use your brush just to get some of this paint and put it onto a palette like this. Now, you'll see throughout this video I use a palette, and I recommend you do the same. It's incredibly useful. The reason for it mostly is so that you can thin your paint down with a bit of water, so just a little bit like that. Add it into the mix, because what this does is smooths down the paint. It means that it'll go on to do miniature smoother, it'll avoid any brush marks appearing, it'll go a bit further, all those kind of things. It's a really useful habit to get into mixing your paint like this. You want to bring it down to about this kind of consistency before you apply it. Then all you've got to do is load up your brush and start painting it all over the flesh of your Troggoth. As you can see, there's quite a lot. Don't worry about finer details for the time being, just make sure that you get all of its skin base coated with this colour. I finished applying that colour all over the flesh, including both of his hands as well, just here, and now we're going to move on to the next colour, which is Demonette Hide. Now, this is to mark in some of the darker areas of the flesh, and because we need a little bit more control now, I'm going to be applying this with a medium base brush. But you want to get your paint ready in the same way as what we did previously, by getting a bit onto your palette like this, and then build up a little dollop there like that, then adding some water into the mix. And I want to have slightly more water than we had previously, because I want this colour to be a little bit more transparent, so it blends in a little bit with the colour beneath it. So I'm going to bring it down to about this kind of consistency here. You can see it's a little bit transparent on the palette. And then what I'm going to do is start applying this to all the areas of the flesh where the colour is darker. So this is going to be on both legs, going to around about the knees. You can see it's just a little bit darker than the previous colour we painted on. That's going to go all over the toes as well. And also, we want to paint in the nose at this stage too. So from around about there down to the tip. Now, one of the areas that we need to paint at this point too is the back, where you can see it's all kind of craggy around here. This area needs to be darker as well. With those two colours now blocked in, we're ready to move on to the next step, which is to add some shade to the miniature to really bring out the texture of the flesh. Now for this we're going to use Druky Violet, but we don't want to darken the skin down too much and make it too dark, so what we're going to do is dilute it using Lamia Medium. Now Lamia Medium is essentially shade paint, but it has no pigment in it, which means you can mix it with other shades and dilute it without changing the paint's properties, so you still get that nice smooth finish once it dries. Now for the mix, what we're going to go for is a roughly half and half, and I'm going to use a medium shade brush to get this ready. So I'm going to start out with the Druky Violet. I'm going to get a good little puddle of it on my palette there like that, so that's two brushfuls just there like that. And then make sure before you get any of the medium out of the pot you clean your brush, because you don't want to contaminate it with any of the colour. So there we go. So now I want a roughly equal amount, so one brushful on the palette there, a second brushful, there we go, and then mix them together. Now if in doubt, put a little bit more Lamia Medium in than you think you need, but you want the paint to be looking sort of like this in your palette before you start to apply it, and what you do is just load up plenty on your brush, and all you've got to do is paint this all over the flesh on your miniature like this. Once the shade is completely dry, we're then ready to move on to start highlighting the miniature. And for this, first of all, we're going to return to Warp Fiend Grey, but this time the application is going to be quite different. What we're going to do is dry brush it on this time, using a medium dry brush. And to do this, what you do is just get a small amount of the paint on the tip of your brush like this, and then get some tissue and use it to work the paint into the bristles in a circular motion just like this, then just check the tissue to make sure that you haven't got much paint left on the brush. You see, I'm getting quite a soft effect with it there. That's perfect for what we need, because as we apply this to the miniature, we want the paint not to fall into the recessed details, but instead to catch the edges. So what we're going to do is, first of all, in the lighter areas, be quite heavy with this, like this, so we get a nice smooth finish on the flesh. But as you get to the areas where the darker colour is, for example on the nose, get much lighter with it so that you just get a little bit of this colour catching on the edges, giving you a nice quick highlight. With that dry brush applied, you can see the colour starting to get lighter, and is also nice and smooth as well. And what we need to do now is push it a little bit lighter by using Slanesh Grey, but applying it in just the same way. So still with a medium dry brush, I'm going to use the same technique, just getting a little bit of that paint on the brush, then getting some tissue and using it to work the paint into the bristles like this, And then once again, all you got to do is start lightly applying this to the miniature. As before, concentrating the colour on the areas that are softer on the flesh, so the belly, for example, in this circular motion to build up the colour like this. But as you get to the rougher areas around here, just be much lighter, just flicking the brush like that, so it just catches the edges of that texture. And there we are, the colour's getting lighter, but we just need to go a little bit further. So now we're going to use Pallid Witch Flesh, again dry brushed on. This time though you need to be careful because this colour can be a bit too stark if you put on too much at once. So make sure you use a small dry brush this time and really make sure that you get rid of most of that paint on the tissue. Really work it into the bristles like this, and if in doubt, make sure you just get rid of a little bit more. So we want the brush brought down to about that point, and then it's the same application as before. Once again, using that circular technique and focusing it more on the lighter areas, such as on the belly like this. You see very softly like that, so the colour's not too strong. You see it's softly building up there. And then just be really light on the darker parts on his back. And there we are, we've now got a nice soft highlight on the body, and we're now going to move on to adding a little bit more sharpness to it. Still with Pallid Witch Flesh though, but this time I'm going to be using a small layer brush, and I'm going to be using a highlighting technique here where what we're looking for is to pick out all those sharp features on it. So use your palette here to get the paint ready, putting a little bit on there like that, and then adding a touch of water into the mix so it's nice and smooth like this. See, it's a little bit transparent, perfect for what we need here. And then what you do is just twist your brush to get rid of the excess paint and bring the bristles to a nice tip. So what we're looking to do now is on all the lighter areas of the flesh, look for those edges where the dry brushing has started to catch the corners. For example, on the face just here, you can see how it's been catching that crest on the cheek. What I'm going to do is just paint a small amount of this colour along there like that, just to finish off with a little bit of sharpness and help that feature stand out a bit more. So all you need to do now is carry on going all the way around the body like this, looking for these finer areas and just picking them out like this. With that highlight applied, the skin's looking really good, and we've actually just got a little bit left to do to finish it off now. And first of all, we need to go to Druky Violet once again, but this time we're going to apply it very selectively. So what we're going to do is use it just to help redefine some of the recessed areas, but also to darken down the nose. Now I'm going to use the palette again just to make sure that my brush isn't overloaded basically here. So just get a little bit of paint on there like that, and then just twist your brush to get rid of the excess. And what we're looking to do first of all is look for any recessed areas that are looking a little bit shallow. So for example, just along there where it's a little bit light in that recessed area there, you can just run a bit of this paint in like that, just to make it a little bit darker and make it stand out a bit more. Now another thing to do here is of course the nose, and we want to make it quite dark towards the end. So what we're going to do first of all is apply a first coat to this, and we'll apply a second one later, but for the first coat what you want to do is paint on like this up to around about where that nostril is, then quickly get the excess paint off your brush with some tissue and then just pull it a little bit further like this so that the colour fades out into the lighter purple up here. And once that shade is dry, apply a second coat of Druky Violet, but this time a little bit further towards the tip. So around about this point here, apply a coat like this, and then as before, get the excess paint off your brush with a piece of tissue, and then just pull the paint up a little distance like that to make the colour fade in towards the lighter purple up there. Now that the nose is complete, we can move on to finishing off another small detail, and that is the lower lip. And for this, all we need is Caribou Crimson and the medium layer brush to apply it. And for this, you don't need very much of the paint, but remember to use the palette to make sure that your brush isn't overloaded, because you don't want to lose control of this paint when you're applying it onto an area like the face. So just use the palette like this, getting rid of the excess, and then once you've done so, all you've got to do is start painting it over the lower lip, just down here. And with that applied, we're now going to move away from the purple details and start painting some other areas of flesh on the miniature. This is going to be the lighter, fleshier colour first of all, that's on the inside of the ears and areas such as that. And for this, what we need to do is start out with a base coat of Bugman's Glow. Now I'm going to be applying this with my medium layer brush once more, and again I want to use a palette here just to make sure the paint's nicely thinned down. So add a little bit of water in, as always, just to bring it down to around about this consistency here. And then also make sure just to twist your brush as you bring it along to bring the bristles to a nice point so that you have lots of control over it, because now you need start picking out some finer details. So there's a few areas to paint with this colour. First of all, we want to paint the fleshier colour on the inside of the ears, so we're talking about this kind of area here. We also need to paint the gums that you can see, and also these bits in the side of the mouth just there. We need to be sure to paint the tongue as well on the inside there. And another detail we need to paint at this point is the loincloth down here, and this will include both the skin and also the fur that's in the middle of it. Once you've finished applying that base coat of Bugman's Glow, you're then ready to move on to adding a layer of Cadian flesh tone. And I'm going to stick to the medium layer brush to apply this, and what we're looking to do is to paint this mostly in the same areas, but just avoiding deeper recesses so we retain the darker colour in those areas. So, as always, add some water to your paint, but this is really about making sure you've got lots of control over it, so it can be more delicate and precise about where exactly you're placing it. So once you've got it down to about that kind of consistency, what we're looking to do is to avoid corners where we painted this colour earlier. So, for example, look at the ear here. We've got a kind of corner running all the way around the outside of it there. So what I'm going to do is paint towards the middle of it like this, so it's lighter on the middle area like that. Now, when you're doing the loincloth area, what you want to do is apply it towards the edges of the skin along here, but don't paint it over the fur. We will come back to that later on. We just need to keep Muggins Glow for the time being. And with that layer complete, we're now going to move on to the next step, which is to shade down these areas and also help them blend a little bit better in with the rest of the purple flesh. For this, we're going to use Druky Violet again, but as earlier, we're going to use Lamia Medium to dilute it so the colour's not too strong. So I'm going to go for the same kind of mix what we had last time and start out with some Druky Violet, get a brush full of that, and then I want roughly an equal amount of Lamia Medium. So again, always be careful to make sure that you don't contaminate the medium with any colour. And then all you've got to do is get roughly equal amount, mix them together like that. And there we go. Now I'm using a medium layer brush to apply this, and all I'm going to do is paint it all over these lighter flesh areas that we've done. So for example, the inside of the ears, I'm going to paint it all over that area there like that. Now as you get down to the loincloth, be sure to get the flesh around the outside, but don't go onto the fur, just keep going around the edge. And once that shade is completely dry, you're then ready to move on to highlighting all these details. And for this, we need Kislev flesh, and I'm going to be applying it using a small layer brush. Now, as always, you want to use the palette to get the paint ready, and it's really important now, like when we were layering early on, you need lots of control here, because really what we're looking to do is just to pick out the edges on the texture of this flesh. So once your paint's thinned down to about this kind of consistency, and you've got that fine tip on your brush, you're looking for all those edges. Now, the loincloth is really easy to do for this part, because you can angle your brush so it's about 45 degrees against those details, and just lightly brush it across that corner to get a nice sharp highlight really quickly and easily. When it comes to areas such as the skin around the ears though, just look for the areas of texture such as little holes in it and just go around those areas like that. And with that, the paler flesh is complete, but we still need to do a little bit on the fur. For this, all we need is Agrax Earthshade, but what we're going to do is apply two coats of it because we want it to be really dark. I'm going to use the medium layer brush for this because whilst we've got quite a large area to cover, I don't want to lose control of it and get it on that light flesh colour. So for that reason, I'm still going to use the palette to help control how much I'm applying at once. But you just get your brush loaded up, and all we're looking to do is to paint it over this fur in the middle here, just being really careful when you get to the edges of it and meet that lighter flesh. And once that Agrax Earthshade has dried, apply a second coat in the exact same way, once again only onto the fur. And with that shade dry, we're going to leave the fur for the time being and start applying some other base coats to the miniature. And we're going to start out with Balthazar Gold, which is going to be for the cannon that's around his neck, and then we're going to need Lead Belcher for some very small details of silver. After this, we need Steel Legion Drab, and this will be to base coat the haft of the club, and then we're going to move on to Carrick Stone for all the rope. After that, we'll need Dawnstone, and this is going to be for all the stone details, and finally, we need a little bit of Lauren Forest for the vines on his back. But first of all, we're going to be applying Balthazar Gold, and I'm going to be applying this using a medium base brush, and as always, you want to use the palette to help get the paint ready here. So just a little touch of water mixed in there, so it flows nice and smoothly, and once you've done so, all you've got to do is paint all of the bronze parts of this cannon around his neck, just being really careful though when you get close to the flesh, just along here. Also with Balthazar Gold, be sure to pick out these little moon designs we've got hanging from the earrings and the ears, and then you need Lead Belcher for some very small details, which is the chain that's just connecting to them. So these little bits just here. Those details base coated, we're now going to move on to the club assembly for the moment because we need to base coat all the wood using Steel Legion Drab. And as you apply this colour, just be careful of the skin when you get close to the hands. The next colour we need is Carrick Stone for all the rope. Now this appears on both the club and also the Troggoth's body, so be sure to take your time and make sure that you get it all. The next colour we need is Dawnstone to paint all the stone on the head of the club. And with that done, we can now return to the main assembly of the Troggoth to paint some small details at the top here with Lauren Forest. Now we've got to do these little vines that go around here, and also there's a very small little frog just on top of here, be sure to base coat that as well. And with all those base coats now applied, we're ready to move on to shading them. And all these can be shaded at the same time using Agrax Earthshade. However, for this, I do recommend using two different size brushes. Have a medium layer brush for the more detailed parts, but a medium shade brush is great for the larger details, such as on the club. Well, whatever the case though, definitely make sure to use your palette so you can control how much you're applying at once. And I'm starting out with my medium layer brush. I'm going to start on some of the details that are on the Troggoth's body. So if we take a look at the rope here, you can see what I mean about being careful, because as I do this, I don't want to catch the skin. I just want to paint the rope like this. So we're looking to base coat all these new colours that we've added, so the bronze, the silver, the rope, all the wood and the stone, and also the green parts up here as well. With that shade completely dry, we're now ready to move on to highlighting all these colours. And first of all, we're going to finish off all those metallic details. And for this, first of all, we're going to return to Balthazar Gold to bring back some of that shine. Then we're going to highlight them with Cycorax Bronze before finishing off with a fine highlight of Stormhost Silver. But first of all, we need Balthasar Gold, and I'm going to be applying this with the medium layer brush. And what we're looking to do here is to apply this colour onto the flatter areas of the detail to make those parts a bit shinier, but not to lose all the shading that we've got in the recessed details, so you want to avoid those parts. So as always, use the palette to get the paint thinned down and ready, and as you apply it this time, you're looking for those darker areas where the shade has settled. For example, we've got these little corroded holes in the body of the cannon there, so what I'm going to do is apply this colour around them, avoiding those recessed details so that we retain the definition of the shade. Next, we need Cycorax Bronze, and this will be applied using a small airbrush, because what we want to do here is paint this along all these sharper edges of these details. So on the cannon barrel, I'm looking at following lines such as this edge along there, and also for all the little pitted holes we've got in here, I want to go around each of these as well. And finally, add a fine highlight of Stormhost Silver, and for this you only want a small amount on the very sharpest edges, such as just along here, just to give a fine highlight and a bit more definition along these details. Also, don't forget to get the little bits of silver on the earrings at this stage as well. And with those highlights applied to the metallic details, we're now going to turn our attention to the stone that's on the head of the club. Now to do this, we're going to first of all lightly dry brush it using Administratum Grey to start to highlight it, but then we're going to add some patches of Athonian Camo Shade to it, because what this will do is give it a kind of damp, mossy finish. But first of all though, we need to dry brush it using Administratum Grey, and I'm going to use a small dry brush for this, because we need to be careful where exactly we apply this, because we need to paint this around all that rope. So as before, when we were dry brushing, use the exact same technique to get the paint ready. Just get a little bit on your brush, then get some tissue and use that to work it in amongst the bristles like this, and also to get rid of the excess paint. And once you've done so, all you've got to do is start running the brush back and forth across the texture of the stone. So you see around here, as I start flicking the brush like this, the colour starts to catch the raised areas and gives a really nice texture to it. So you can see though, the ropes, as I get close to those, I'm just going to be really careful to avoid getting this colour on those details. And once you've finished dry brushing, you're then ready to add some Athonian Camo Shade in small patches with a medium shade brush. And just paint it in small areas like this, and randomly scattered across the stone. And with that shade dry, we're going to leave the stone for the time being, because now what we need to do is to highlight the wood. And for this, we're going to dry brush it using Carrick Stone. But then we're going to do a dry brush of a Shabti Bone on a lot of details to finish them off. So this will include the stone, the rope, the wood, the vines, all the details like that. We're also going to return to the fur and the loincloth to finish that off. But first of all, we need Carrick Stone, and I'm going to be sticking to my small dry brush to apply this. And as before, what you want to do is use the tissue to make sure you've only got a very small amount of this paint left on your brush. So really work it into the bristles like this until only a very small amount is appearing on the tissue. And then all we need to do is start picking out the texture on the wood of the club here. And to get this, what we want to do is go across the texture this way so that we catch the edges like this. And then finally, we need to apply a light dry brush of a Shabti Bone. Now on the club, this is going to be across all the details except for the flesh. So be careful around there, but make sure you catch all the other colours at the same time to tie them all together and give them a really nice finish. Now also, we need to do some dry brushing on the Troggoth's main body as well. And for this, I recommend switching to your small dry brush, because for this, the details are much finer. We need to get the rope on here, and you can see I'm just putting my brush at an angle on the side like that, just to catch the texture of the rope and to avoid the cannon around there. And the same on the skin, just really taking my time. Also, be sure to get the fur down here as well. And there we are, with all those details highlighted, we're now going to move on to painting all the fungus that appears all over his back, and of course there's some bits on the club as well. Now first of all, we're going to do the kind of fungus that looks kind of like barnacles. For this we need a base coat of Rakarth flesh first of all, followed by shading it with Druki Violet, but dilute with Lamy Medium again so it's not too strong. Now after that we're going to dry brush it very lightly with Rakarth flesh just to lighten up a little bit, and then add a highlight of Pallid Witch flesh to finish them off. But first of all, we need Rakarth flesh to base coat them, and I'm going to do this with my medium base brush, but have a small airbrush on hand for the really small ones that are quite tricky to get to. But for all of these, again, use your palette just to make sure your paint's ready and so it's under control. Then all you've got to do is just take your time going around the miniature picking all these out. And as you can see, there's loads and loads of these. It's these round ones here that I'm talking about. And you just need to really take your time to make sure you catch them all. Once you've finished all the base coating with Rakarth flesh, you're then ready to paint all over these details with a 50-50 mix of Druki Violet and Lamia Medium applied with your medium layer brush. Once the shade is completely dry, we're going to return to Rakarth flesh, but this time dry brushing it very carefully towards the top of this fungus. So you can see I'm just taking my time to make sure I get a soft colour along the top of them, but I'm being careful not to catch the skin around them. With that done, we can now move on to Pallid Witch flesh to highlight them. Now there's two steps to this. First of all, dry brushing it very lightly, once again following along them like this, so you get a light colour appearing towards the top of each one. And then still with Pallid Witch flesh, but using a small layer brush this time, add a highlight going around the tops of each of these ones that are open. So just a fine line running around here. With that fungus done, we're now going to move on to the next area of fungus, this time the yellower ones. And for this, what we need is a base coat of Baylor Brown, and then we're going to highlight them using a Shabti Bone, before finishing off by shading them down using Seraphim Sepia. But first of all, we need Baylor Brown, and I'm using my medium layer brush to apply this. And again, use your palette to make sure you've got the paint under control, because these details, they are quite small now. So make sure it's thinned down nicely and that your brush isn't overloaded. And once you've done so, the kind of fungus we're looking for this time are these narrow ones, such as just along here. You just want to pick them out as neatly as you can with this colour, both the top and the bottom. Once you've finished the base coat, you're then ready for a highlight of a shabty bone. And for this, use a small airbrush and just paint along the edge of each one. And finally, apply a small amount of Seraphim Sepia over each one. And there we are, the yellow fungus is done, and now we're ready to move on to that blue fungus. Now, for all these mushrooms, what we need to do first of all is paint the top of the really big one that's on the top of the back. And for this, we need Thousand Suns Blue for our first colour. I'm going to be applying this with my medium layer brush, and as always, use the palette here. But for this first step, all you've got to do is make sure you get a nice even base coat across the entirety of that cap on the mushroom. So once the paint is thinned down, we're looking at painting this area up here. Now don't worry about the spots, we will do them later on, but for now you're just looking at this outer coating going all the way up here. Once you've applied that base coat, we then need to add some depth to it by adding some shade. And for this, what we need is Drakenhof Nightshade, but we're going to apply two coats of this to make it a little bit darker around the middle of the cap. Now, first of all, I'm going to be applying it using my medium layer brush for the first coat. And for this first one, all you want to do is make sure you've got a good amount in your brush and paint it all over the top of that cap. So we're looking at this area around here, making sure it settles nicely in those recessed details as we go. Once that shade is dry, we're ready then for the second coat of Drakenhof Nightshade, but this time focusing in a kind of band around the middle of the mushroom's cap. So around about this area here. So there you get a darker ring around that area. With that shade dry, we can now highlight this blue cap. And for this, what we need first of all is to return to Thousand Suns Blue, and we're going to apply it in a very specific way this time. I'm still going to use my medium layer brush for this, but what you need to do is make sure that you get that fine tip on your brush on your palette. So add that little bit of water in, twist the bristles to bring them together like this, and then for this highlight, what we're looking to do is to apply it in lines following the texture of the mushroom's cap. So if you take a look at it, you can see we've got these ridges running vertically down it all the way around. What you want to do is follow that direction by painting this on as lines like this, because you can see what it does is help build up that feeling of texture on the mushroom. You want to go up about this distance here, so this distance to around about that spot just there, and from the top down, go to around about there. Once you've finished applying that colour, we're then ready to move on to the next colour, which is Araman Blue. And for this, we're going to be doing much the same technique, although pushing the colour a little bit further toward the top and bottom of the cap. So prepare your paint in the same way, but this time I recommend using a small airbrush so you get slightly finer lines for this. But still thin it down just as before. You want to bring it down to around about this consistency. And then, as before, get those bristles to a nice tip. And so this time what we're looking to do is just go a little bit further down towards the bottom. So I'm going to go to around about there, painting those lines on again, like that, to build up that texture. And from the tip of the mushroom, we want to go down to around about there. With the Araman Blue applied, you can see the texture and the colours really building up nicely now, and what we need to do is finish that cap off with a highlight of Baharoth Blue. Now I'm going to be applying this again using the small layer brush, and this time we really don't need very much of it. We want to be quite precise about where exactly we're placing it, just around the edges really. So once you've got that paint ready, we're looking to pick out those areas. Now, what you want to do is do that lower corner of the mushroom. Actually, the easiest way to do this is to turn the model like this, and just angle the brush about 45 degrees against that edge, and then you can just run it across that edge there like that and get a nice highlight, and then follow these ridges going up a little bit there like that. Now from the tip, you just want to go a short distance down this time. It's not very far, just from the very tip there, just a little bit down like that, going all the way around. And there we are, with the blue of that cap complete, we can now move on to the next colour that we need, which is Celestra Grey. And we need this for quite a lot of details, because now we need to pick out the spots that are on that cap. We also need to do the body of that mushroom, but also we need to base coat all the other mushrooms that we've not touched yet so far. So there's quite a lot of these scattered all over the body, on the club. There's even one with a face on it on his back, but just make sure you take your time so that you catch them all. Now, for this, I'm going to be using a medium layer brush mostly, but you might want to have a small layer brush on hand as well, for some of the really small, tricky to get to details. But whatever the case, as always, use your palette to get your paint ready. And once you've done so, all you've got to do is take your time picking out these details. So, as I said, we need to paint the spots that are on here first of all, just base coating around the middle here, leaving that dark colour around the outside. You also need to paint the body of this mushroom and the underside of it as well, including this part just here. So take your time with that to make sure you don't catch the blue. Now, also, you're looking at painting all these other mushrooms, such as this one just here, and be sure to get this one as well with a face on it that's on his shoulder. With that base coat now applied, we're ready to shade all of these mushrooms. And for this, what we're going to do is use Nylac Oxide. But as with some other shading on the miniature, we don't want the colour to be too strong here. So what we should do is dilute it using Lamia Medium. So as before, we want a roughly 50-50 mix here. So I'm going to start out with the Nylac Oxide by popping some on the palette there like that. And then make sure the brush is clean before I get any medium so I don't contaminate it with any colour. And then we want roughly equal amount. So let's put those together there like that. So there we are, we're looking for a mix kind of like that. And once you've got it, all you've got to do is apply this over all the Celestial Grey details. So just like this, so it runs into those recessed areas. Now the one area to really be careful on here is when you get to these spots or on top of this mushroom. When you're doing these parts, just keep it on the Celestial Grey areas like this. If any runs into those recesses, you can redefine them quite easily by just using a little bit of Drakenhof Nightshade just painted into those corners. With that mix now dry, we're going to leave that mushroom that has the face on it for the time being, because now it's time to finish off the caps of all those smaller blue mushrooms. Now for this we need Araman Blue first of all. I'm going to be applying this with the small layer brush, and this stage is really simple. It's actually a lot like when we were doing some of those highlights on the larger cap mushroom earlier on. What you're looking to do is to paint some lines on the mushrooms following the direction going vertically up towards the top of them. So what you need to do is make sure you've got that fine tip in your brush so you have that control. And the easiest way to orientate this is to hold your brush kind of at this sort of angle compared to the mushrooms. I'm going to do this one just here. And what we're looking to do is to paint lines like this, going up towards the top, all the way around each one like this. So you just need to take your time now doing this technique. And once you've applied that to the caps of all those small mushrooms, you just need one more colour to finish them off, and that is Xerius Purple. Now this is going to be applied in just the same way, still using the small layer brush, and make sure on your palette to really thin this one down so that the colour's not too strong. You don't want it to be overwhelming on these mushrooms. So bring it down to around about this point here, then make sure your brush isn't overloaded, and what we're looking to do is to put this just on the very tips of the mushrooms. So if I start on this one again, same technique of painting those lines, but just up around the tips like this. With all those blue mushrooms now complete, we're ready to finish off that one that has the face on it. And for this, first of all, we need to highlight it using Pallid Witch Flesh. And then for the eyes, we need to prepare them by darkening them down using a little bit of Agrax Earthshade. After that, to paint the yellow of the eyes, we need Avalanche Sunset, and we can also do the Troggoth's eyes at the same time here. And then to finish them off, we'll need a dot of Pallid Witch Flesh once more. But first of all, to highlight the one with the face on it using Pallid Witch Flesh, I'm going to use my small airbrush once more. And what we're looking to do here is just to essentially pick out all the sharpest edges on the features just to help them stand out. So once you've got your paint thinned down and you've got that fine tip in your brush, all you're looking to do is to look for those edges and essentially follow along them. So you can see we've got the face that's expression along there. What I'm going to do is just look for those corners and just follow along them like this with this colour just to help them stand out a little bit more. With those highlights applied, you're now ready to add a little bit of Agrax Earthshade to the eye sockets. Now when you're doing this, just be careful not to overdo it. You only want a little bit like this just to help define the shape of the eyes. Then pick out the eyes with a very small amount of Avalanche Sunset, just keeping your hands as steady as possible as you just dot the colour to the eye like that. And then also be sure to pick out the eyes of the Troggoth as well. And finally, add a dot of Pallid Witch Flesh to the centre of each eye just to make them a little bit brighter. And with those very small details done, we're now ready to paint in all the bone details. So for this, we've got things like the teeth, there's also the nails, and of course, there's some skulls in the miniature as well. Now for this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Zandri Dust and then shade over these details with Seraphim Sepia. After that, we need a layer of a Shabti Bone, and finally, we need a very small amount of Pallid Witch Flesh to finish them off. But first of all, we need Zandri Dust, and I'll be applying this with my medium layer brush to start with, though feel free to have your small layer brush on hand because some of these details are quite small and tricky to get to, for example, with the teeth. So take your time with this stage to make sure you get all these areas, but essentially what we're looking at is, as I said earlier, we've got the teeth, and as you're doing these parts, just be careful of the tongue and gums as you base coat this detail in around there. We need to paint the nails as well. Now I've got the toenails here, but of course on the club we've got the fingernails as well. And then there's also some skulls. So we've got this quite large one just back here, that goes just around here with that mushroom growing out of its eye. But also there's a very small hidden one just around here, so be sure to get this one as well. Once you finish the base coat, you're then ready to shade over all these details of Seraphim Sepia, making sure you get it all over all the details of Zandri Dust. With the shade dry, we're now ready for a layer of a Shabti Bone. Now on the teeth and the nails, the technique for this is to paint lines on going from the tip of them downwards like this. So this way you build that texture going in the direction of the bone's growth. So on the nails, it's actually easier to do it the other way around, but still those lines going towards the end. So paint it down like this to build up this kind of texture, avoiding those recessed details. There we go. Now for the skulls instead, what we're looking to do is to paint this onto the flatter areas where the shade didn't settle. So if you see this one just here, you can see it all settle in those little recessed bits between the teeth and stuff. So as I apply this, what I'm going to do is look for those parts and avoid them. So as I get down to where the teeth are, you can see we've got some shade in that bit just there. So I'm going to avoid that. Some shade where it goes down to the teeth, so I'll avoid that. And this way I keep the definition from the shade whilst also brightening it up and picking out the detail. And then finally, apply a highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh. Now on the teeth, it's just a case of just doing a few lines towards the very tips of them like that. And on the nails, it's the same sort of process, just a few lines just towards the very ends like this. For the skulls, though, what you want to do is look for the sharper edges, and with this, just start following along those with this colour, just like this, to pick out these details. And there we go, with all those bone details finished, there's now just one more thing left to paint on the miniature, and that is a little bit of verdigris on the cannon that's hanging from around his neck. Now for this, we just need nylac oxide, and only a very small amount of it, applied using a small layer brush. Just make sure you don't put on too much at once here, just really get rid of the excess on your palette. Then all you've got to do is paint it into some of the recessed details on the bronze. So, for example, just in these little parts, just here like this, to add a bit of colour to it. Now, once done this, all you need to do is make the final assembly of your miniature, and I recommend using super glue for this. Don't use plastic glue because it'll melt the paintwork around the arms if you're not careful with it. And then all you've got to do is base your miniature, and as always, we recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. With the base completed and the final assembly made, this Dankhold Troggoth is complete, ready to be roused from slumber by the gloom spite and to be sent into the enemy lines to start smashing them apart, this massive club. So when you're painting this miniature, there's a few things to remember, and the first is that we used quite a lot of Larmium medium throughout this video. Now, I did this because we wanted to dilute the shades so that they weren't quite so strong in colour, but we didn't want to change their properties, and we certainly recommend that you use Larmium medium for this and not water, because if you do so, you'll get a smoother finish to the paint. Now also, we did quite a lot of dry brushing on the skin in particular, and when you're doing this, just remember to build the colour slowly so that you get a nice smooth transition from the darker areas to the lighter areas. And finally, when you get to those finer details, just remember to take your time and be as neat as you can, because the neater you are, the better the final result is going to be. Now, we hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and we really hope you have lots of fun painting your Troggoth, and we'll see you all again very soon.